Sally, now, I don't know if I'm nervous or just glad to finally be doing it. We meet at 3. One last load of laundry, look for coffee cups. I wonder if I seem anxious or scared waiting a week to meet. Neither is true. I worry about the effect of perception. Eat a bit, move some boxes, maybe a quick run. I have 2 hours to be complete. Moving the things a mom keeps, making sure the car starts, drilling the roots to implant poison. I just want to make sure I'm ready when she gets here. Everything in order, the price understood.
All right.
Shoe cancer. She's a mermaid drowning in fur. She has face cancer, but it's not contagious. Her life is strapped into the dentist chair, secured under that heavy radiation bib. Bills to pay, cancer notes, poem. She's a mermaid in $476 Kate Spade shoes. Asphalt is not her medium. Grit is not her purpose. She's a mermaid. She knows she's a mermaid because she just can't breathe this air. Because her hair wisps out like seaweed, because she keeps her crotch closed. But now they're telling her she's only a girl, spinning lies on a dying earth. They say she has attitude cancer, contagious. That she needs to polish her phrases to fit. Sometimes she's just plain angry. She stamps her high heels and shakes her fists. Everywhere the sharks sharpen their teeth, sign paychecks, rubber nose into her business. It's late afternoon and she wants to soak her face in the green sea, to breathe in the mystery of the fishes, to forget she ever owned a vagina. A poem that I wrote while I was living in, when I was living in southern Florida. And we started with lines and like a rolled up bill. My boyfriend put a used car lot up his nose. He had $50,000 left. He bought $5,000 of cocaine as an investment.
My kind of guy.
We snorted so much that when he told me the streetlight was a helicopter snooping in our living room, I believed him. He decided to let his friend up north distribute the product. Driving up 90, he thought, all the cars were transporting cocaine because they were all driving the speed limit. Cocaine is my least favorite drug.
Yes, it is.
This is a pretty quick one. Economic indicators. I've availed myself to the information. What I do with it is how I will be remembered. A million transgressions got me to this point. Heartbreak has job security in a depression. Obligation to make money. Even Buddha's been cheapened for me. It's the double-edgedness of any compliment. I wasn't sure if it was stand-up or poetry. As I was not, you were not standing on this side of my eyes. Pennies flattened for scrap. Open negotiations a must. I felt my heart today after a week of being content. The disconnection notice is a sign. It's too late. Woo!
Go, Wendy. Go, Wendy.
Go, Wendy.
Go, Wendy.
Go, Wendy.
White girl! Growing up in the 50s, stripped of deciduous and coniferous vitality. Homogeneous, plopped down like tract houses on a parched surface. I hugged the bark and pulled myself up the branches beyond the giggles of Barbie, her unresistant breasts pointing at Ken. Beyond the lessons from my mother, stuck in her own spotless sludge of suburbia, stuck in her own jaded morass of traded power. White girl learning the language of bulldozers, framed in public press release ease. Marriageable, marriageable, marriageable. Not me! White girl stick, legged can't dancer, laugh too loud, white gloves, and knees eternally pressed together. Not me! Homogeneous, good girl speak by rote. Not me! How the 50s clung to those last white girl rules, putrid and false and stinking and starch! Before the pill came imploding a tired plastic etiquette. Before breasts popped out of their pointed brassieres.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Woo! Before Reefer and Janice and Angela breaking free. Homogeneous? Not me. Not me. Not me! Poem for my dog Justin, who's gone now, and it's called King of the Jungle.
Okay.
He's a chow and husky. He has a handsome, handsome pup. My dog chomps down on chicken bones with his long, sharp teeth, pulverizing skeleton into meal. His ancestry unleashed in my mind, I know he is born to bite down on whole chickens feathered in his great jaws. But he serves me, human, just a cow with an evil brain. These silly little bicuspids couldn't even rip open a rabbit. But the evil that is my brain could grow whole colonies of blind chickens to fry up for the dollar. She's ready.